sit up on the attack. Baby, I'm bad. I just wanna get caught up in this life. I'm crazy, I'm mad. Do it, no cap. Only got one, so you better go live it up. Cash in the bag, stadium packed. Baby, I'm bad. Baby, I'm bad.
What's good, you guys? It's your girl CeCe, aka Cecilia Robinson, aka CeCe Reacts. And I want to thank each and every one of you for tuning in with me today. Before we get started, I need for you guys to like, subscribe, and share the video. Also, please hit that bell so you know when I'm coming on. Listen, I'm gonna ask you guys, I really, really need y'all to share the videos. YouTube be on so much BS with me, hiding the content. People don't know I post it. Share the videos, you know what I'm saying? Be a friend. Let people know, you know, what's going on. Also, I want to say this. I heard you guys' request. I listened, and I've developed something brand new for you guys. The How Did I Become a Criminal series is now available to CHAV members only. You guys have been rocking with me. Y'all have followed me through my whole prison journey. Now, hear the story on how all of that came to life. How did I take those steps in order for me to go to prison? Yes, it's available now on the CHAV. This is the first of several series that's coming to the CHAV. Listen, it's some fire content, and you guys will not be disappointed. So anybody who hasn't joined the CHAV, listen, if you want more stories from me, the CHAV is where you need to be at. And if you want to hear how I end up going to prison, check out How I Became a Criminal. Sign up. I promise you, you will not be disappointed. And once again, thank each and every one of you. Now I want y'all to sit back, relax, and enjoy this fire content, this fire episode, and y'all be smooth. Have a dope day. Y'all listen, when the police, firefighters, and the ambulance pulled up to get old girl, I took that opportunity to go to the back and fix me some garlic parmesan wings, and I grabbed me two little cups of ranch, and I sat in the back. No, I did not have it in me to make a statement. I don't care. I didn't have it in me to give a backstory of what I seen. I'm not making a damn it. You know what I'm saying? It's not my problem. Not my problem at all. All this could have been avoided if Cynthia would have sent old girl home. It just is what it is. So I stayed in the back eating my chicken wings and licking my damn fingers. And yep, I was fat as hell at that point in time. I had gained so much weight because every time something happened, guess what I was doing? I was eating. It was my coping mechanism. No, I'm not a drug addict. No, I'm not an alcoholic. I couldn't steal nothing no more from the bank. So what I did was ate. Food was my best friend. It is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Once I felt like the coast was clear up in the front, I didn't hear any more commotion. I came out the back. I washed my hands, and I found Cynthia standing in the middle of the floor. Now, she's standing in the middle of the floor. The bitch looked lost. I got to be honest with you. She looked out of it. You know what I'm saying? So the way she was looking, I thought, oh, girl, had croaked. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, yo, I'm like, did she make it? She said, yeah. I said, well, what's wrong? What you looking like that for? You know what I'm saying? She said, I just do not want to lose my job. She said, I can't afford to lose my job. I'm on parole. She said, they already critical of me. She said, they watch everything I do. She said, I done made a few mistakes. She said, I don't want to make no more. You know, listen, I'm not going to lie to you. I was happy she was feeling that way. I was glad she was feeling that way. Another thing, this is exactly what she got. You know what I'm saying? I felt like the whole situation could have been avoided. Another thing, listen, I don't know what they're taught in Pittsburgh as far as schooling goes. But what I do know is black people act really weird out there when it comes to white people. You know, and I'm going to say this. She would have never in a million years gave Nate the opportunity that she gave this bitch Chastity. You know what I'm saying? She would have never. Nate was clean now. She still could not stand the sight of Nate. You know? But yet, you had a bitch with clear signs that she was a junkie. All them damn holes in her arms, all the scratching, you know, all the movement and the permits week. It was clear signs that this lady was a junkie. Not only that, she took the first opportunity to go to the bathroom and get high, came back and nodded out while she was on the damn clock, slobbing all over your customer's food. And instead of you firing her or sending her home, you had compassion for her and you told her to go over there, sit down, get something to eat till her high comes down. Black people have a sense of compassion for white people that they would never have for black people. You know what I'm saying? In her head, because I'm not that way. You know what I'm saying? Because people is people. It is what it is. You know, in her head, and she never said this, but I seen the way she act. You know, white is up here, black is down here. You know, our reality, these people, they do the same damn thing. You know, white people have just as many problems as black people. They have just as many issues, if not even more. You know, what make you think that she's above any damn body else? She was a damn junkie. So once again, I didn't feel bad she was feeling like that. You know what I'm saying? She deserved to feel like that. You know, she really felt like that because that veil she had over her eyes was slowly coming apart. You know, that bitch, she's a human. She do stuff. You know, it is, listen, they even bolder. You know what I'm saying? White people way bolder than black people when it comes to certain things. Because, listen, it is what it is. We're not going to get off into it. We know what the hell it is. Sorry. Anyway, I want her to feel that. You know what I'm saying? She goes on to talk about how Saeed, you know, she don't know what to say to him and how is she going to fix this, and she's asking me my opinion. So I tell her, I say, listen, because at the end of the day, I'm still a friend, you know. I tell her, I say, listen, I say, you ain't got to tell Saeed a damn thing. She, what you mean? If he haven't received the call already or he haven't checked the camera, you don't have to say anything. You know what I'm saying? Wasn't no money stolen. The store didn't burn down. You know, you got up out of here. She got proper treatment. Just don't let that bitch come back up in the store. You know what I'm saying? And if he asks what happened to her, she quit. Or you fired her. Irreconcilable differences. You know the damn word I'm trying to say. My tongue too thick. It don't come out all the time. You know, whatever. But just don't let that lady come back up in here. She tell me you right. You know what I'm saying? Now, me and her, now I'm still salty deep down inside at her. And she's feeling this, you know. But me and her, we still friends at the end of the day. So we got to stand here and have this fake ass conversation and make conversation to try to fix what's broken. You know what I'm saying? We talking about, you know, she asking about Nana and everything. I say I'm waiting on her to call, you know, and all this other stuff. Have it goes. The door opens. You know what I'm saying? Now she's standing on the side of me. Like my back is to the door at the register. So she can look and see the people that's coming in. So she, you got this, yo. You know what I'm saying? And she turns around. Man, she got a phone in her hand. She turns around. She goes to the back. You know what I'm saying? She gone head to the back. I turn around just in time to hear some bitch talking. So, ooh, they got some good food up in here. Big bitch. You know what I'm saying? Now, at this point in time, I'm obese. You know what I'm saying? When I say obese, I don't mean, I mean, I'm just way over my damn weight limit for my body. You know what I'm saying? I got aches and pains and everything. But this bitch, she's gone. I don't know the word, is it morbidly obese? Is it an extra word for the, this bitch big. You know what I'm saying? She about 5'8", 380, 400 pounds. She got some shit hanging in front of her stomach. But I don't, all that is fine and well, but I'm trying to figure out why she was dressed like Prince. The bitch had on a white blouse with a purple velvet blazer. She had on some black tights with some riding boots, and the bitch legs was shaped like the letter K. You know what I'm saying? Knees knocked as hell. How it go? She, ooh, they got some good food up in here. I'm with one of them calzones. You know what I'm saying? Then I see a dude step from beside her. You know what I'm saying? All the time, it's Nate. You know what I'm saying? So I'm looking. He said, you can get whatever you want, baby. He said, I got you. So I'm happy to see Nate out on a date. You know what I'm saying? I'm happy for him. You know? So he look up, he see me, he wink his damn eye, and I put a little smirk on my face. The hell you mean you got her? You know, bitch, I feed you when I feel like you hungry and some stuff like that. What you not gonna do is bring this big bitch up in here and think I'm finna feed her too. So when you saying you got her, I hope you got the funds for it too. Or y'all won't be eating. You know, yeah, I accused them. You know, and I know some of y'all gonna be like, ah, Cece got jealous. Man, suck my dead daddy left nut. You know what I'm saying? I ain't no damn jealous. It's just facts. You know, you don't bring, if you, listen, if I'm feeding you for free, you don't bring the damn crew. You know, now I could have been assuming. Like I said, they come over to the register, not treat their head just like cousin. Hey, welcome to Peace Palermo. How may I help you? You know, oh, girl's like, ooh, you know, I've been wanting to try one of y'all calzones. What's in one? What's in the calzone? I say, you can get sausage, you can get pepperoni, you can get chicken. She said, ooh, chicken. I say, you want a chicken calzone? I hit the button on the computer. You know what I'm saying? Hit the button, it's a picture. All you gotta do is hit the button and put up in there. She said, no. She said, I want all the meats. I said, you can get all the meats? No problem. I put all the meats too. You know what I'm saying? Calzone is expensive as hell. You know, I say, anything else for you? Now, meanwhile, she's standing right in front of the register. She big as hell, so she's taking up that little space. So Nate is trying to squeeze his body, you know, over there too, so he can talk, because he's got something to say, because he want to order something. You know, anything else for you? She said, yeah. She said, give me some of them cheese fries. I said, okay. I said, I got you. You want some cheese fries? She said, can you put some pizza sauce on it? I said, I sure can. You know what I'm saying? You get some cheese pizza fries. I got you. You know what I'm saying? You want some meat? She said, yeah, chicken. I got you. You know, ring, ring, ring. Expensive, expensive, expensive. You know, so Nate say, that's all you want, babe? She said, I want a pop. I said, okay. She didn't call it a pop. She said, I want a soda. I said, okay. You know what I'm saying? She said, 2 liter. Oh, oh. I said, 2 liters over there. She said, I'm going to get it. I want to stay cold. I want to stay, okay. You know what I'm saying? So Nate say, that's it for you, baby. She said, yeah. So Nate say, I want some wings. He said, I want some garlic parmesan wings. He said, I'm the best wings y'all got. I say, yeah. I said, I just had some. You know what I'm saying? So she said, ooh, garlic parmesan wings. You know, she said, what size they come in? I said, they come 12, 24. She said, give them 24 wings. I want some. I said, so y'all want 24 wings, you know? She said, yo, she said, can you split it up? I want my own because I don't want him touching my 12. I said, I got you. You know what I'm saying? I said, I know how it is. They like this. Go ahead and ring it up. You know what I'm saying? When it get through, total is $65. You know what I'm saying? So I'm trying to figure out. I hope Nate, I know you looking eye. I hope you got some funds for this because bitches ain't finna be free. You know what I'm saying? So he get to digging in his pocket. Now when he dig in the first pocket, he patting too damn hard. You know damn well ain't nothing over there, Nate. You know what I'm saying? He go ahead and dig in the second pocket. You know, digging the back, just start patting his back pocket. What the hell you keep patting for, Nate? You know what I'm saying? Somebody got to pay for this. He go ahead, he reach in his little jacket pocket, and he pull out a wallet. You know what I'm saying? Now, I got a crew, because y'all was going to be some hungry asses today. He go ahead, he open up the wallet. Now, when he getting ready to dig in his wallet or whatever, the door opens again. You know what I'm saying? When the door opens again, the crackhead bitch walk in. Who was the crackhead chick? The crackhead chick who was with him the night he stole the damn television. The bitch who was carrying the 2 bags. The extra strong crackhead chick. You know, so she come walking through the door. You know what I'm saying? So the big girl look at her and she stand the big girl down. You know what I'm saying? So the big girl say, ooh, bitch, you following us? Nate, you need to get her, Nate. You need to get her. So Nate like, hold on, what you doing? So a girl walk over there on Nate's side, you know? So at this point, Nate is the in-between them. You know what I'm saying? So the big girl, she done turned around and she looking, Nate stand, you know, like an ice cream sandwich. And Nate is the one in between. So the crackhead, she turned out, she said, you bad fool, Nate? You bad fool, Nate? Bat me something. So Nate said, I ain't got nothing for you. You know what I'm saying? And he told her, watch out. And he turned his back. Now, when he turned his back, he got his wallet in his head. Old girl tried to reach around and snatch his wallet. The big bitch knew if old the crackhead snatched the wallet, then it was going to be a problem. She couldn't get her food, so she popped her hand. You know what I'm saying? So girl said, oh, bitch, you done messed up. You done put your hands on the wrong one. She throw her little strong crack arms up. You know what I'm saying? So I tell her, I say, hey. I say, you got to take that outside. You know what I'm saying? I say, these are paying customers. I say, you can't be fighting up in here. So she tell me, she said, I'm a paying customer too. I want some. I say, okay, you're going to have to wait till I get through taking their order. You know what I'm saying? I said, then it's a possibility you're going to have to take your food to go if you can't settle down. It is what it is. You know what I'm saying? I asked Nate and his girl, his lady friend. I say, this is for here to go. You know what I'm saying? They say it's for here.
You know? So she, yeah, it's for here. I want my food hot. Ooh, and all this other stuff. Okay, cool. Nate go ahead and he pay the money. You know, I get Nate his change. Nate go ahead, you know, him and old girl, they go over and they find him a table. The little crackhead chick, she tell me to get her a slice of pizza. I said, okay. I said, I got to make a fresh pizza because we ain't had no more slices. We was out of slices. It was late in the day and it was slow. You know what I'm saying? She said, okay. She paid for it. She gave me a $5 bill. Slice pizza, $2.99. You know what I'm saying? Come with fries. I get her a change back. All the time, though, she go ahead and hand on over to the damn table where Nate and old girl is. You know what I'm saying? Now, while I'm over there fixing everybody damn food and everything, I hear the chairs constantly moving, and I hear noise, and I hear arguing and every damn thing. They keep getting up. They look like they playing musical chairs because they keep moving table from table because they don't want to sit with the crackhead bitch. You know what I'm saying? My whole thing is, like, I got to be honest with y'all. Did I feel bad for the crackhead chick? No. You know what I'm saying? Nate was in jail for 30 days. He took those 30 days to get himself clean. You know what I'm saying? I know he was your crackhead buddy out here on the street. You know, I done seen y'all together a few times. But since he went to jail, why didn't you take those 30 days and use the same 30 days to do the same opportunity? Well, you had the same opportunity. You could have got clean too. What, you thought he was going to come out of jail with a crack rock, gift wrap for you? You know what I'm saying? And it looked like you trying to pull him down. Leave that damn man alone. You know, so like I say, they finally get tired of playing the musical chairs or whatever, you know, and they finally settle back at the original table, and no girl's still sitting there. Now, they sitting there, all three of them, they awesome arguing amongst one another. You know what I'm saying? I don't give a damn. Long as nobody swing. You know what I'm saying? I tell them, hey, don't nobody swing. Everybody can be cool. You know what I'm saying? So old girl tell her, she said, I won't hit her up in here. The crackhead said, tell me. She said, I won't hit her up in here. She said, I'm going to wait till I get outside. The big dick tell her, she said, well, when I get outside, she said, I'm going to stump another asshole in you. You know what I'm saying? They saying what they going to do to one another. Okay, cool. Let me know when it happens so I can get my phone and I can start recording. It is what it is. I fix all their food, get everything, and I take everybody's food at the same damn time. You know what I'm saying? I was good. Bah, 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 bah. You know what I'm saying? The big bitch, she got her calzone, she got her wings, she got her fries. You know what I'm saying? She got everything in front of her. The little crackhead, she got her slice of pizza. Nate, he got his wings. You know, the big chick, she go ahead, she pick up her calzone. She pick up the calzone instead of her taking a knife or fork and cutting it. You know what I'm saying? Like she got some home training. She picked the damn calzone up like it's a peanut butter and jelly sandwich and bite into the back of them. Arr! You know what I'm saying? Listen, her biting into the back of it not only upset me, but it upset the damn crackhead too. She called her a hoghead hoe. You know what I'm saying? She told her, she told her that she bet she liked Nate licking the rolls in her back with her fat ass. I'm talking about she vicious, her tongue vicious. You know what I'm saying? The crackhead, she ain't touched her pizza. You know what I'm saying? I think she wanted some crack. She thought it was going to spring some, but she ain't touched her pizza. Nate, however, is telling no girl, why don't she gone about her business? You know what I'm saying? He don't want to mess with her no more. He on a different path in life. You know, she telling Nate, shut the hell up. When she get outside and she whoop his bitch ass, she said, you better not touch me because you're going back to jail for domestic violence. We'll have to ban this, that, and the third. You know what I'm saying? Old girl, she stopped talking. The big girl, she done stopped talking. She sitting there, she eating her food. You know what I'm saying? She picking up the wings. She just pulling the meat off. You know what I'm saying? Strong as hell. She's trying to show her strength. You know what I'm saying? She's trying to show her strength, and then she's trying to show it to the crackhead. Crackhead not buzz. She not fake. She talking crazy to her and to Nate. You know what I'm saying? When that when the big bitch, she finally eat her last wing, and she gone ahead and ate that cow's on like it was a piece of watermelon. You know, chewed out all the inside, left the rain around there. She put it down on there. It was just the cross part. Listen, she put it down. She sat back from the table. She told her, she said, now I'm through with my food. She said, now I'm finna eat your ass up. You know what I'm saying? She said, I'm finna dog walk you. I'm finna dog walk you, bitch. You done talk, you done bought the right ticket today, bitch. You done did the best to be. And she hyping herself up. Now, Nate, instead of him telling her to calm down or whatever, he telling her, my baby, when she say that, she don't play. And he hyping her up too. You know what I'm saying? So Nate and the big bitch got the confidence that she gonna whoop the crackhead. You know what I'm saying? So listen, they getting up the crackhead like, man, we can do this right now. No, you can't. Take it outside. You know what I'm saying? Take it outside. I only got my phone on to record just in case some stuff happens. I still want to be ready. I want this fight. I like fights. I love hood fights. It is what it is, especially if it ain't man. Listen, Nate get up, he head to the door, he talking, man, and he coaching his girl. Man, you better beat her ass. She been asking for this. Beat her ass, old girl. Ooh, I know she had. She done followed up. She done followed, so she walking. You know, Nathan opened the door for her. So she taking her earrings out, and she walking through the door. Meanwhile, the crackhead up there, she done plotted everything. She run up behind her. You know what I'm saying? When she run up behind her, she take her knee and hit the back of old girl's knee. Now, I don't give a damn how strong you is. Your knees gonna buckle if somebody touch the back of your knees. And if you 300, 380, 400 damn pounds, your weight is heavy on your knees. That's why I had to lose weight. My knees was killing me, goddamn it. Listen, when I say that big knee buckled, she buckled like a folding chair, and old girl hit her in the back of her afro. Boo! She fell flat. And old girl went around her whooping her ass like the Tasmanian devil. And Nate telling her to get off. And while she whooping old girl, listen, she telling Nate, if you touch me, you're going to jail for domestic. If you touch me, you're going to jail. If you touch me, you're going to jail. Old girl trying her best to crawl. Every time she put a hand, old girl stomping her hand. I'm talking about she tore her ass up. When it was all said and done, the big bitch had her arms wrapped around old girl's leg, begging her to stop hitting her. Listen, it's not how big they are, because the bigger you are, the harder you fall. Listen, y'all stay tuned. Be smooth. And Nate, you ain't nothing. Bye.